so many young women and young girls of all races have looked up at me with these eyes that have been so expressive and full of this sense of possibility, not just about me, but for themselves.
Hey, Grio fam, I'm Jerry Keith, the Gaynor, managing editor at theGrio, and I'm here with New York City mayoral candidate, Maya Wiley. Maya Wiley, thank you so much for taking time out to talk to theGrio. The last time I sat down with you, you had just announced your campaign, and we talked about the historic nature of your campaign. You would be the first woman and first Black woman to be mayor if elected. You've now been on the campaign trail for several months. How does it feel now at this juncture in this leg of the race? How confident are you in your chances of winning this election?
Well, thank you, Garen. It's a pleasure to be here with you when we're only a week out from the final primary day. It has been amazing. It has been uplifting. It has been inspiring. It has been humbling. You know, I went to vote today. And it was an extremely emotional experience, both because I went into my neighborhood poll site, a high school where my partner's father went to high school. But I was also walking in the door, you know, full of pollsters who all look like me. Most of whom were Black women, with a love and an energy that really spoke to the nature of the history making. Spoke to the support. It's hard to describe when you've never run for office before and you're a Black woman in a city that's never elected one, and you look down at a ballot and your name is on it. And so many people have just loved and supported you right in through that front door. And so many young women and young girls of all races have looked up at me with these eyes that have been so expressive and full of this sense of possibility, not just about me, but for themselves, for what it represents about what they can do, who they can be, but also what will happen for them, whether there'll be someone in City Hall who can hold and respond to their experiences. And it was just really overwhelming. And I'll tell you, I'm the progressive that can win this race. We're feeling really good about it because we have amassed the support of, first of all, every single congressional representative from Brooklyn, including, you know, Hakeem Jeffries as a senior leader in our party in Washington, but also in this borough of Brooklyn and in the city. Congresswoman Yvette Clark, who herself has made history, Congresswoman Nidia Velasquez, first Puerto Rican woman elected to Congress. And of course, most recently with Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, which really, you know, had said she wasn't coming into this race and really shocked and surprised everyone, including myself, by saying that the stakes were too high and that I was the progressive we needed. And the momentum and support that it built from there has just been incredible. And so we're feeling really good, and I'm feeling the love and the energy and the Maya-mentum, as we call it in the campaign.
The Maya-mentum, I like that. Speaking of that crucial endorsement from Representative Ocasio-Cortez, that was a major get for not only as a progressive, but she represents the millennial generation and has such a strong following and huge voice in the Democratic Party. What did that endorsement mean to you?
Yeah, well, she's a tremendous leader. She is extremely intelligent, very deeply principled. She is about big and bold change. You know, when she ran for office, her slogan was courage to change. And for me, both the coalition that she represents and what her leadership represents has been hugely exciting and inspiring. And a big part of the message that I am delivering and that this campaign is delivering to the city of New York about the level of transformative change we need. I want to be very clear, though, that we have also come to this moment because 1199 Service Employees International Union came in and supported me in February of this year. That was an incredible honor and incredibly important for winning elections in New York City politics. You know, they fight and they win, and they are essential workers, from our home health aides to our nurses, all the folks we were cheering for all through COVID, who are asking for something much different in government and came in and supported me. And they've got over 200,000 members who vote in Democratic primaries in this city, all saying they are coming out for me, and getting the entire Brooklyn delegation. We have a candidate in this race who's the Brooklyn Borough President, and yet the entire Brooklyn delegation to Congress, which is a powerhouse group of leaders, all of whom have made their own history in various ways, all have endorsed me before Congresswoman Ocasio-Cortez. So for us, you know, this momentum was building. This was a huge crescendo, and I'm excited by it. Congressman Jamal Bowman coming in as well with his endorsement. But really the consolidation of the progressive vote in this city, which is Black, which is Latino, which is white, which looks like the city of New York in all of its mosaic beauty, but is also deeply grounded in transformative change that really makes sure that our communities get the investments that they deserve in order to make sure that this is a great city to raise a family in, no matter what zip code you're in or what you look like or who you love.